A very good morning to all the students of class 12th political science, and students, welcome back to the online classes here. As you know very well, we were doing the first chapter of our book, that is the part B, politics in India since independence, and we were doing the first chapter, challenges of nation building, which we had already finished in the last video. So today we are going to start chapter number 3. So now you must be thinking that why we are not doing chapter number 2. For that I would like to show you the contents first, so that it would be clear to you, as I have already sent you the PDF also, and I sent you a link also which is in relation to the new revised syllabus given by the CBSE for political science. But still I am just showing you once again through your contents. Okay, so these are your contents of your two books. This is part 1, Contemporary World Politics. We have already finished this, and these chapters have been removed, and third chapter, some topics of this third chapter, that is US hegemony, has been added and merged with chapter number 2, that is end of bipolarity. This I have already explained to you, and these two chapters have been completely deleted. So, and many topics have been removed and added, which we have done it properly. Now we were into the second book. So we have done almost all the important topics of this particular chapter, challenges of nation building. But if you look into the second chapter of this book, that is the era of one party dominance, this chapter has been added to with the fifth chapter, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This, so era of one party dominance, we shall be start reading some of the topics of this particular chapter, with chapter number 5, dealt challenges to the Congress system. So some of the topics we shall be taking when we will be reading chapter number 5 of this second chapter. Otherwise this second chapter, we can say this is removed or deleted, but some part of these topics have been merged with chapter number 5. So that is why after completing chapter number 1, I am directly into chapter number 3rd, which is politics of planned development. But if you will see in the revised syllabus, yes, one more important thing is there. These names have also been changed, and the new proposed names or the contents of these chapters have been given. Like today we are doing chapter number 3rd of this book, politics of planned development. But if you see according to the new revised syllabus, the new proposed name for this chapter is only planned development. Okay, so we shall be taking only planned development, and in this chapter we'll see which topics we have to take. So as I told you, this is chapter number 3. This is the part 1st of this chapter. Politics of planned development was the old content, and the new name for this chapter is planned development. This has been removed. Only we'll study about planned development. This is the new proposed name for this third chapter, and under this I would like to show you the two important topics we are going to study. This is a short chapter. All the major and important topics related to planning commission and 5-year plan have been removed from your syllabus from this particular topic and chapter. Only two topics we have to do in this chapter, that is National Development Council, or we can also say NDC in short. We'll call it NDC while we will study this chapter. And other topic will be Niti Aayog. So we'll try and understand these two important topics and these two are completely in relation to planning commission and 5-year plans. But we will see the objective functions and importance of these two in this chapter. But today I shall be taking only one part, only one topic, that is National Development Council, in this particular video. So I hope you have understood that what we are going to study in third chapter, and why we have skipped second chapter and directly I am reading the third chapter. So let's start this topic. Yes, National Development Council. So under this chapter, first topic is National Development Council, popularly we call it NDC. So let's see the first point here. National Development Council is an executive body established by Government of India in August 1957. If you read it, it is very simple. If you see it, it was established by Government of India and date is in August 1952. So this is very much clear to you. But the important thing which you have to see here is executive body. Why we are calling this National Development Council as a executive body, and I hope this word is very much clear to you. You have already learnt it and in detail in class 11th. Okay, so this is one of the important organ of the government, executive. So why we are calling this National Development Council as an executive body, which was established by the government of India in August 1952? Let's see. There are few bodies. Some are constitutional bodies. Okay, if I'm talking about some bodies like constitutional bodies or non-constitutional bodies, so in that, what do you understand by constitutional bodies? It means mentioned in the constitution. Any bodies about which something is mentioned in the constitution, some provisions, articles, rules, regulations are given in the constitution, that body is said to be in the as a constitution body. As some articles are available for election commission, some are for some for Supreme Court. So some articles are for this and some for Supreme Court. So that is why we can say these two and many more, and these two, for example, I am taking, we can say these are the constitutional bodies, because article specified article is given in the constitution, which describes their functioning, their objectives, and why they have been established. Okay, but on the other hand, there are some non-constitutional bodies. It is very clear from the word itself. Non-constitutional bodies means any bodies whose mention whose relevance is not given in the constitution. Nothing is written about these bodies in the constitution, but that is why they are called non-constitutional. But under non-constitutional, there are two type of bodies: statutory bodies and non-statutory bodies. So what are statutory bodies? Established by law. Any laws made by the parliament. You know this process very well. In class 11th, you have done how the laws are made, how the bills are drafted and brought to the Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, how they are passed by the both the houses, how president signs it and makes it a law. So there are various laws which are established by the parliament. Such laws or such bodies which are made by the laws are called statutory bodies. But some are non-statutory bodies. These are established by executive. What do we mean by executive? You must have heard of the term Council of Ministers. When we were reading in class 11th about executive, you must have read an important organ. This is executive. Under this, there is a Council of Ministers headed by the Prime Minister, and its head is the President. So, non-statutory bodies are which, through a simple provision given by or passed by the executive, they establish some body. That bodies are called non-statutory bodies. So we can say, coming back here, if you read it now, I've explained you this and this types of body just to make you understand this definition. National Development Council is an executive body established by Government of India in August 1952. Government of India, we can also say Council of Ministers. So these Council of Ministers have passed a resolution and they have established an executive body whose name is National Development Council. And if we are using the word executive, it means there is no mention of this particular body in the constitution, or it is not passed by any law in the parliament. It is directly proposed by the executive body. Okay, that's why I have explained you these two points. So what the conclusion we get from reading this definition and showing you the distribution of type of bodies in our country. So we can say NDC, National Development Council, is neither a constitutional nor a statutory body. So I hope if there is a one mark question, you can answer it very clearly. So NDC is not a constitutional because there is no article mentioned in the constitution regarding NDC. It is not a statutory body as there is no law passed in the parliament which has established this particular NDC, but this was directly proposed by executive. So we can say it is an executive body, or we can say it is a non-statutory body or an extra constitutional body. It is the apex body to take decision on matters related to approval of 5-year plan of the country. So apex means at the top level. If I talk about the courts, Supreme Court is the highest court in if we talk about the judiciary. In the same way, if we are talking about this particular field of planning commission or 5-year plans, so this NDC is the apex body, the supreme body to take decision on the matter related to approval of 5-year plan. So whenever there were the planning for the 5-year plan or planning commission planned any plan, the approval was given by NDC. So NDC was the biggest and the most powerful body at the apex level who approved all the plans proposed by the National Planning Commission. So Prime Minister is the ex-office chairman, or we can simply say Prime Minister is the chairman of the NDC on recommendation of first five-year plan. So this NDC, National Development Council, came into existence after the recommendation of the first five-year plan. So our planning commission was established in 1950 for the very first time, and from 1951 to 1956 it was the first five-year plan. So during that first five-year plan, there was a recommendation that there should be a body like National Development Council which would approve or help this planning commission in executing the plans properly. Or we can also say it is an advisory body. It gives advices for the or to the planning commission. Okay, and now this planning commission is no more into existence, and in place of planning commission now we have Niti Aayog. If we talk about Niti Aayog, the full form of Niti Aayog is National Institution for Transforming India. Okay, so now after 12 five-year plans, this planning commission was abolished, and in place of it a new body came into being, that was Niti Aayog, National Institute for Transforming India. Okay, so previously this NDC was working for planning commission, as it was a advisory body to planning commission, or we could say it was the apex body to give approval to the 5-year plans in the country. But now instead of planning commission, there was another body which is called Niti Aayog. So NDC has to meet at least twice a year. If we say about talk about the NDC, National Development Council, which gives approval to the 5-year plans, okay, made by the planning commission, now NDC has to meet twice a year. In a year they had to meet twice for the meeting, for the discussions. Is moving forward now. Further going, we'll see the next point, which is the important one. NDC, National Development Council, had last meeting was 57th, total number of 57 meeting. If we count it from 1950 or from 1951, when the first 5-year plan was launched, after that there were total 57 meetings, and this last 57th meeting of NDC was held in 2012. And why in 2012? Because in 2012 the last 5-year plan was established, I would say, was given by, and this last plan was from 2012 to 2017. To approve this for last 5-year plan, and after this planning commission was, I would say, abolished. So to give the approval for the last 5-year plan, NDC met for the 57th time in 2012. This was the last meeting of NDC, National Development Council. In relation to planning commission, this was the last 5-year plan given by the planning commission. So this was the 57th meeting. Reading more, there was some other important facts about it. Like in 2016, there was a provision given that there will be abolished NDC and transfer its power to the governing council of Niti Aayog, but not yet done. So I will explain this point at the last of this chapter once again. But now you can understand that in 2016 it was proposed that now after abolition of planning commission, we should also abolish National Development Council. Okay, we should abolish this body and transfer its all powers, whatever the powers and composition and objectives were of NDC, those all should be given to the governing council. This is a body or a part of Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog is a independent body, a executive body. Under it, there is a body that is called Governing Council. So it was said that the powers of the NDC should be transferred to the Governing Council. It is a part of Niti Aayog, but not yet done. But still, this provision is still in progress or in process, and I will discuss this point at the last. So this diagram I have shown you so that you can understand how the Planning Commission used to work, and how the things and the how at the different levels the different functions of the different bodies were held to make various plans successful. Like draft of 5-year plan, previously it used to be draft, what will be the 5-year plans in the future, and what all things, how you will allocate the resources and economy at the different sectors. After drafting of this 5-year plan, it went to Planning Commission. Now, Planning Commission, after understanding it, they passed this 5-year plan draft to the Union Cabinet. Now, this is the important, all the important ministers are under the Union Cabinet, at the top level ministers. Now, these ministers, after seeing it, passed this particular draft of 5-year plan to the National Development Council, that is NDC. And after NDC, after it sees to it, it passes it to Parliament. At Parliament, then the discussions take place over that particular draft of the 5-year plan, and finally the final decisions are taken in the Parliament. So if we see through this chart, I'm trying to explain, Parliament is the highest, or the, at the apex level, I would say, of functioning. At the second level, we can say is the NDC. It was a powerful body which had all the important personalities within it, including Union Cabinet. As we know, the chairman of this NDC is the Prime Minister. And in the composition, we shall study which are the members, who are the members of this NDC. Okay. Now, moving forward, we will see the objectives. What were the important objectives of NDC? So the important objectives of NDC, National Development Council, were to strengthen and mobilize the effort and resource of the nation to support the plan. Whatever the plan has been given in the 5-year plan, we have to put all efforts and we have to put all the resources to making that plan a successful plan, to mobilize this, to strengthen, give strength through that particular plan. We have to put all our efforts and all our important resources. For example, if we are talking about the 5-year plan related to agriculture and we are talking about irrigation in the rural areas. So to promote and to strengthen this plan, to bring this plan as a successful 5-year plan, we will have to put all our efforts, we will have to use all our resources to mobilize and strengthen the national plan. Okay. To promote common economic policies in all vital spheres. So to promote common, the economic policy should be common to all the important places in our country. So the places which require have the, I can say, capacity where there can be a lot of production or the economic growth, the common economic policies should be established there. Okay. To ensure the balanced and rapid development of all parts of the country. Okay. So we don't have to, if this is a map of the country, this should not be done that we are only going and developing only few parts of our country. We are only making 5-year plans to develop only few parts of our country which can be beneficial. But what were the major objective of NDC? To ensure in the 5-year plan, they always ensured that there was a balanced and rapid development. There should be a fast development, but it should be balanced and in all parts of the country, not only selected parts, but the all parts of the country. There should be equal common economic policies established and with the balanced and rapid development. So in additional to all these objectives, we can say in additional to this, NDC provides a platform. Through NDC, there is a platform where all the states can meet and they can discuss their problems and issues related to development. So whether there is any discrimination or inequalities between the states, so there is a platform, that is NDC, where they all could meet and discuss their problems and issues relating to development or to relating to 5-year plans. Thus, it secures cooperation of the states in the execution of developmental plan. So it was very important. So the states plays a very important role in the execution of the developmental plans given by the NDC or the Planning Commission. So that is why it's written here, it secures the cooperation. So cooperation of all the states is very important so that there is a proper execution of developmental plans and there is a rapid as well as balanced development in all the parts of our country. So your role of states is very important here. After objectives, now the next thing is, what are the functions of NDC? Objectives, so we have seen that what are the objectives. Now what were the functions of NDC? The first one is to prescribe guidelines for the formulation of the national plan, including the assessment of resources for the plan. Suppose we have a national plan already decided that, okay, this will be the 5-year plan and these are the things we have included in this particular plan. So the work of NDC was to give few guidelines according to which these national plans and these objectives are the objectives are and aims are to be achieved. So these guidelines were given by NDCs to achieve the aims and objectives of the national plan. Okay. Second is to consider the national plan as formulated by the planning commission. It was the responsibility of the National Development Council that they have to accept and formulate the national plan which has been put forward by the planning commission, and now it is called Niti Aayog, as I told you. Okay, now this work of planning commission is done by Niti Aayog, but previously it was the responsibility of National Development Council to consider the national plan as formulated by the planning commission. So you must know that there were total number of 12 5-year plans, okay, and the last one I told you from 2012 to 2017. To make assessment of the resources required to implement a plan, and this was also the function of the NDC to make sure and see the assessment of the resources required for implementation of plan. As I told you, what is the plan and what are the resources and efforts required to make that and execute that plan properly. So it was responsibility of NDC. For example, we are making road in the rural areas of India, and we're trying to reach give electricity to each and every part of the rural areas or the backward areas, okay, or the isolated places. So it is the responsibility of NDC to see to that all the resources are provided properly, which are required by the plan for its proper and good execution. To consider important questions of social and economic policy affecting national development. It was also the responsibility of NDC to consider important questions. If there is any plan, we have under that plan, we have to see all the social and economic problems or the economic policies which can affect the national development. So it was the responsibility of NDC to look into the social and economic policies which could affect national development relating to any national plan. And the next is to review the working of the plan from time to time. And it was also very important, if we have planned, certain plan is decided by the planning commission and it has been accepted by and approved by NDC, but it was also important to give a review and reconsider it from time to time, because with time and changing time, there are many situations which changes with time. So it was very important to review the plan from time to time. Now the next thing is, and the important one is, composition. Who are the members of this NDC? So coming to the composition now, National Development Council is composed of the member mentioned below. These are the members who make the composition of NDC, National Development Council. So the most important, as I told you, Prime Minister of India, he is the chairman of NDC. So all the chief ministers of the states, okay, all the chief minister of all the states in India. Administrators, or we can say governors of all union territories, those union territories where there is no chief minister, so all the governors are included in this National Development Council. Okay, all cabinet ministers, all the important cabinet ministers of the Council of Ministers, or we can say also include it in the executive part. And the most fifth is members of the Planning Commission. Also, some of the members of Planning Commission, these are the members of Planning Commission, were also included in this National Development Council. So it would have been easily to connect what was the actual plan and what these members will be deciding and debating on the various issues relating to 5-year plans. So it was very important to keep all the members of Planning Commission within the this particular body, that is National Development Council. They should be the member. The secretary of the planning commission is also the secretary of the NDC. A person or the officer who is the secretary of planning commission, he is also the secretary of the NDC. Okay, but as I told you, now planning commission has been abolished, and in place of there is Niti Aayog. This is functioning for planning commission now. Now, these are the important points here. Since the inception of the Niti Aayog, since the Planning Commission has been abolished and this has been came into establishment, Niti Aayogs, there is a body within Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog, there is a body or a part of Niti Aayog is Governing Council, which has almost the same composition and role as the NDC. So, Niti Aayog has taken the place of Planning Commission. So you need to understand it properly. So instead of Planning Commission, now we have Niti Aayog. But within Niti Aayog, there is a body or a part of Niti Aayog that is name is Governing Council. Okay. And we will see the composition. If you see the composition of the Governing Council or the objectives and functions of the Governing Council, they are same as we have read about NDC. This topic we have all read about NDC, National Development Council. We have seen the definition, we have seen its composition, we have seen its objectives, we have seen its functions. So all these characteristics of NDC are also having within Governing Council of a part of Niti Aayog. So the NDC has no work assigned to it, nor did have any meeting. So from a long time since Niti Aayog has come into existence in place of Planning Commission, along with it, this Governing Council has started working in place of NDC, because NDC's work, everything is done by the Governing Council now. So there is no work assigned to NDC now, neither there has been any meeting. As I told you, the last meeting I told you was the 57th meeting in 2012. This was the last meeting of NDC. After that, there has been no meeting of this particular body. Now, NDC has been proposed to be abolished since abolition of the Planning Commission, as I told you. Since this Planning Commission was abolished, along with this Planning Commission, it was also proposed by the people or by the parliament or the people of a country that this body, NDC, should also be abolished. Why NDC should be abolished? Because the work of NDC is now done by Governing Council. And this Governing Council is a part of Niti Aayog. I hope you have understood what I am trying to explain here. It's like a chart, you can understand it. Along with Planning Commission, it was proposed that NDC should also be abolished. Although NDC plays a very important role in the Planning Commission, but here the work and the composition of NDC was the same like Governing Council. So now the work of NDC is done by the Governing Council. So it has no more been assigned any work, nor there has been any meeting of NDC. But till date, no resolution has been passed to abolish it. It is not functional. NDC, it is not functional, but it is not abolished yet. We cannot say that NDC is abolished. It is not functional because in place of it, Governing Council of Niti Aayog is working and functioning for Niti Aayog to plan various things for the country, for the welfare of our state. But NDC has not been abolished yet. It is prevalent, but it is not functioning currently. That's why it's written. But till date, no resolution has been passed to abolish it. So this was all about the topic, that National Development Council. I hope you must have understood it, and I shall be assigning few important assignment to you based on this particular assignment or this lecture. And this is an important lecture. You shall be getting important questions from this, as this is the new prescribed topic given by the CBSE in their new revised syllabus. So we need to do it properly. I made notes for you. So you need to write these notes properly, as I have shown you the definitions and its establishments, all the important dates. I made you the charts also. I have shown you the composition and functions as well. So I hope you will do this properly. Okay, now I come to end of this topic. Till then, thank you.